Hi everyone, my name is Kim and I'm a nutrition educator with Cornell Cooperative Extension. I work with the SNAP Ed program. Thank you for joining our lesson today for the Catch Kids Club. Let's go over a few ground rules before we begin our Zoom lesson. For our lesson today, everyone will be on mute. So go ahead and check your sound right now and double check to make sure that you're on mute. If you happen to have a question, you can either raise your hand or type it in the chat box. We're going to talk today about physical activity and eating healthy. Did you know the right mix can help you be healthier today and in the future? By the end of our lesson today, you will know the healthy benefits of doing physical activity. You'll be able to identify body cues that happen when doing physical activity. And finally, you'll be able to identify the five food groups and name examples in each of those food groups. For our first lesson, we're going to talk about why it's important to be active and move your body. These are two things that help you stay strong and healthy. Let's start by everyone making a muscle. Let me see your muscles. That looks great. Everyone's looking strong. Let me ask you this. How do you think we make that muscle stronger? Go ahead and put some ideas in the chat box. I see some push-ups, some pull-ups. But you guys are onto it. It's exercise. When your arm is strong, it helps you to do things like lift a heavy box or throw a ball. Now, everyone finds your heart. Not only is your arm a muscle, but your heart is also a muscle. It's an amazing muscle. Let's check out some of the things your heart does. It works all day and night without ever stopping, pumping blood and oxygen to all parts of your body. To make your heart strong and healthy, you have to exercise it, just like you would your arm muscle. To exercise your heart, you need to move your body and be active every day. Let's find out about physical activities that help your heart. We're going to call physical activities go activities. You can tell if an activity is a go activity from certain changes in your body while doing these activities. These changes are called body cues. A few examples of body cues would be a fast heart rate, sweating, a warm feeling in your face, or breathing harder. Your heart pumps blood through your arteries, and then it rests, and then it pumps, and then it rests. You can feel this pumping and resting action when you put gentle pressure on the large artery in your wrist. Let's check out how we can find our pulse on our own wrist. If you're sitting still, you should have a slow, steady, resting pulse. Everybody go ahead and try it. There I go, I found mine. Can everybody else find theirs? Give me a yes. If I see a no, I'll try to help you out. So how do we get that pulse to go faster or speed up? Anybody have guesses you want to put in the chat box? That's right, we do it with physical activity. And every time we make our heart rate a little bit faster, we make that muscle a little bit stronger. So we're gonna do a quick little physical activity to get our heart going. What we're gonna do is run in place for 30 seconds. I have a timer I'll pull up on my screen that will count down. So everyone go ahead and stand up, give yourself enough space and make sure to watch out for other people around you. I'm about to pull the timer up, so get ready. Ready, set, go. Let's run in place. Here we go. Getting our heart rates up. Making that muscle stronger. First 10 seconds down. You guys are looking good. We're halfway there. Almost to 10 seconds. Now let's run as fast as we can for that last little bit. We've got 5 seconds left. Get those heart rates going. And whew, we made it. Nice job, everybody. I can feel my heart rate going a little bit faster. Think about those body cues that we talked about. Go ahead and put in the chat box some of the body cues you're feeling. I'm gonna catch my breath while you do that. So that's right. Like I said, I had to catch my breath, breathing a little bit harder. I see some warm faces. Feeling a little sweaty. Those are all good cues that you are doing go activities and making your heart and your body a little bit stronger. Now let's quickly talk about how many minutes of go activities we need each day. It's best to do go activities for at least 60 minutes a day. If you think that sounds like a lot, don't worry. You can split that time up. You could walk to the bus stop or school with a friend or sibling, and at lunchtime, you can play on the playground or play tag with your friends. After school, you can go for a bike ride or even go skateboarding. What are some go activities that you guys like to do? I see lots of bike riding. Anybody into sports? All of those sports are going to be good too. Soccer, gymnastics. All right, great answers. So you guys do like to be active, and you see, you can split it up through the day and make it an easy way to get 60 minutes every day. While being physically active is important, it's also important that we fuel our body with the right foods. This is My Plate. It's a guide that helps us make healthy food choices. So as you can see, there are a lot of shapes and colors on My Plate. So what do you think those shapes and colors are? Yep, that's right, they're food groups. And how many food groups do you guys see? Yes, that's right, there's 5 food groups. So we're gonna talk about them individually really quick, and then we'll talk about our favorite foods in each food group. First thing that should stand out is half of your plate should be fruits and vegetables. So let's start there. With fruits, you wanna go for the whole fruit. Whole pieces of fruit like a whole banana or a whole apple versus things like fruit juice provide nutrients and fiber that you don't get from fruit juice, and it keeps you fuller longer. Let's look at our whole fruits here. We have grapes, pineapple, watermelon, strawberry. Why don't you guys share what your favorite is? I can tell you mine isn't even listed there. My favorite is blueberries. All right, I see a good variety there, some bananas, blueberries, grapes. Nice job, everybody. Let's look at our vegetables. We want to try and vary our veggies. So what that means is to get different kinds and different colors. We really try to follow that message of eating the rainbow and eating vegetables from all different color groups. From the greens, to the reds, to the oranges, and the yellows. They all have different vitamins and minerals in them that help our bodies in different ways, which is actually pretty cool. Let's take a look at what we have here. Broccoli, carrots, corn, peppers. I can tell you broccoli is one of my favorites. How about you guys? What's your favorite? All right, we've got some good answers. I see a variety of colors just like we talked about. So that's right, you want to vary your veggies. So that's our fruits and vegetables, and you want to remember to power up with fruits and vegetables so you can do those go activities. Now that we've learned to make half of our plate fruits and vegetables, let's take an exercise break. We've run in place and checked our heart rates. Now let's practice our balance. Everybody go ahead and stand up again. You see the picture here, this is called the tree. We're gonna do this for 30 seconds, just like we did running in place. So everybody go ahead and get in position. I'm gonna get our timer up again. And go. Nice quiet breath. That's your first 10 seconds down. You're feeling a little wobbly, that's okay. You can just reset yourself. Squeeze your tummy muscles, that helps you to hold your balance. Just 5 seconds left. You guys look great, strong trees. All right, nice job, everyone. That one takes some practice to hold. You have to get your mind and your muscles in your body to work together so you can stay in that position. If you practice it a little bit, it gets easier. And when you do, you should do it on both sides to make sure that you're staying in balance. All right, let's look at our grains now. Our message for grains is to try to make half of your grains whole grains every day. So what does that mean? That means that we should try eating grain products that are made with whole grains. Eating whole wheat bread versus white bread, or eating brown rice versus white rice, we want to choose the whole grain foods because they have more nutrients and fiber than white grain products. And also, they keep us fuller longer because they're digested slowly. Look at what I have here. I've got some pasta, whole grain bread, some whole wheat cereal, oatmeal. What kind of grains do you guys like? All right, that's a wide variety. And remember, you want to make half of them whole grains while you're making those choices. Let's do another exercise break. This time, we're going to take a walk together. So everybody, go ahead and stand up and let's get moving. I'm just going to talk while we do that. Let's go for our walk. Here we go. So remember, walking to and from school, playing tag in the middle of the day, those are all great ways to get your physical activity in. A good way to make sure you've got the energy to do that is to start your day the whole grain way. There's so many choices to do that. You can have a slice of whole wheat toast, have some whole grain cereal, maybe try oatmeal, or a whole wheat waffle, a whole wheat pancake. There's lots of choices to be able to start your day the whole grain way. And if you want to keep that energy up through the whole day, that's why you want to make half of your grains whole throughout the day. So power up with whole grains. All right, go ahead and sit down. That was a good walk that we just took. I hope everybody's feeling a little energized from that walk. Let's move on and look at our proteins. When we make protein food choices, we want to vary our protein routine and choose leaner protein foods. You see here protein foods that are a bit lower in fat. For example, if you like chicken, get baked or grilled chicken instead of fried. Eating seafood and beans are also great lean protein choices to go lean with protein. Let's look what I have for protein here. We've got some fish, beans, poultry, and eggs. How about you guys? What are your favorite kinds of proteins? That's great. I do see some really good choices here. I can tell you, I love beans. I eat them almost every day. They're one of my favorite choices. All right, let's do another exercise break. One of the benefits that comes from varying your protein routine and eating the right amount of lean protein is that it helps to strengthen our muscles. So for this exercise break, let's try making our legs stronger by doing 15 squats, and we'll see how we feel afterwards. So once again, here we go. Everybody get up. Let's get into position. And a one, two, three, keep going. I hope you guys are starting to feel a little bit, making your muscles stronger. All right, that's 8, 9, 10. Do you think you can do 5 more? 5, 4, keep going. 3, just a couple more. 2, and 1. Whew, okay. I feel a little burn in my legs, which is good. That just means we're making our muscles a little stronger. How about you guys? I also am breathing a little harder. Go ahead and share what body cues you're feeling now. I'm going to take a drink of water to catch my breath while you do that. Okay, nice job. Well, let's look at our last food group. Dairy is a very good source of something called calcium. It's great for your bones and teeth, which is very important because you guys are growing quickly. So at your age, you want to make sure you're getting enough calcium. And you want to move to low-fat and fat-free dairy foods to avoid eating too much saturated fat. So let's look at some choices. You see here, I've got milk, yogurt, and cheese. You guys go ahead and share. What are your favorite dairy choices? Yogurt and cheese and milk. Okay, you guys have got it down. So now, like I said, calcium is in dairy, and it's really good for your bones. And you want to remember, strong bodies need strong bones. So for our last break, let's get up and jump. because any type of physical activity you do that puts impact on your bones forces them to repair themselves by making them a little stronger every time. We'll talk more about that next week when we go over bone health. But for now, let's have some fun. Everybody go ahead and get up. I'm gonna pull that timer up again. Now you can do jumping jacks, jump squats, or you can just jump up and down and dance. I'm gonna put a little music on for this one too. So get ready. 3, 2, 1, and go. All right, you guys are looking good. I see some jumping jacks. Let's try some jump squats. A little bit of dancing. Just jump. 2 more seconds. All right, and we made it again. You guys have done great. I lost my headphone there. You guys did a great job. Why don't you share with me what body cues you're feeling now? I can tell you, I'm a little out of breath. I'm gonna have some water too, because it's important to make sure you're drinking water when you get your exercise. Yep, heart rate's up, warm faces, sweaty, all of it. That's great. So we got our heart rate up and made it a little stronger again. And like I said, when you put impact on your bones from jumping like that, you're making your bones stronger too. Okay, so everything you eat and drink matter over time. Eating a variety of these foods, or a variety of foods from different food groups, keeps our bodies in balance and gives us energy we need when we're performing go activities. What questions do you guys have about my plate? Okay, to wrap up our lesson, let's look back at things we talked about. There are 4 body cues that let you know you're doing go activities. They include heart beating faster, breathing harder, sweating, and a warmer face. Go activities include examples like playing catch, going for a walk, playing tag with friends, shooting some hoops. Let me ask you a couple of questions to finish up. Can you name the 5 food groups? Go ahead and put that in the chat box. Now let me ask you this. How many minutes of go activities do we do every day? Okay, you guys have got this down. So now let's choose some go activities to get our hearts pumping. I'm gonna pull up a poll, and it's gonna list a bunch of different activities, and you can pick 2 or 3 that you think you can do every day to make sure you're getting that 60 minutes of physical activity. All right, go ahead, the poll is up. I'll just watch for it to be finished and drink some more water while you do that. Okay, great. Thank you very much for sharing with us what you want to do to get your physical activity in every day. Let me just show you guys what our most popular answers were. We've got some soccer, we've got some walking, we've got some jumping jacks. Jumping jacks are good because you can do those no matter what the weather, inside or out. Jump rope, playing tag. Those are all great answers and all great ways to make sure you're getting your go activities. I want to thank you all so much for participating in today's lesson. I hope to see you next time. And in the meantime, make sure you're sticking to those go activities and keeping my plate in mind while you eat. Like I said in the beginning, the right mix can make you healthier today and in the future. If you want recipes and other nutrition facts, you can connect with us at snapedny.org. This presentation was sponsored by the USDA, which is an equal opportunity employer.